Greetings, friends. Welcome to day three of TMN Turkey Week, and we got a good one to unbox today. We are doing Wing Nut and Screw Loose from the cartoon show. I am so excited to get these guys open and take a look at them. So let's not delay any longer. Let's see what these guys are all about. Toast! So first, I want to admire the box. We got some cool pictures of the figures there, along with some other recent ones, like we got Mondo Gecko and Kerma, who we unboxed last time, Ground Chuck and Dirtbag, and also Chrome Dome, who stay tuned, because those guys are going to be showing up later in this week too. And we got pictures of how they looked in the cartoon show. So that is way exciting. So first off, this is exciting. They come with a new background. This is the exterior of the sewer lair in New York City. This is really, really cool. I love it. I love that they did this. I don't like that the ground is black and the sides are black, because that doesn't give us much immersion, but it is cool to have something new and something different. So toast. So first, let's look at Wing Nut. Oh my goodness, he is amazing. He's huge. First of all, he is beefy and he looks just like he did in the cartoon show. He has tons of articulation, knee joints, ball joint legs, arms. He's got swivels. He's got bending elbows, twisting hands. His head is on a ball joint and it is so cool. His wings, look at the detail here with his little teeny wings connected to the big robotic wings. And of course, this cartoon was the only time Wing Nut was a villain. So it's this is the villainous form of Wing Nut, alien from another planet who came to enslave military school boys to have them join his army to take over the world. And Wing Nut isn't even the main bad guy. The main bad guy is Screw Loose. He's the boss. Wing Nut is kind of his dumb, you know, sidekick. So here we go. This is like our first real Screw Loose action figure, because Screw Loose before in the Playmates figures was just like an accessory, a little unpainted figure, which I wish I still had mine, because I keep turning his head, because I thought I remembered in the commercial for the original figure that they showed Screw Loose with his head turning. So when I got him, I immediately tried to turn his head and broke it right off the original ones when I was a kid. But yeah, now look at Screw Loose. He's got his four arms, he's got bending elbows, twisting wrists, he's got ball joint legs, bending knees, he's got his nice tap shoes and everything. So these guys look fantastic. He's got wing articulation. Oh, so cool, so cool. Oh wait, before we get into accessories, I want to point this out, that Wing Nut has this terrible paint job in his teeth. Look at the smudges. Look at this big black thing here. It looks like an Oreo cookie is stuck in his teeth. It is ridiculous. And in the cartoon, he had little tiny fangs there over his teeth, and it looks like they just couldn't paint it right. And it is just smudged and it's terrible. Fortunately, Wing Nut is not hard to find. I've been to many Targets this weekend, and all of them seem to have a good number of Wing Nut and Screw Loose figures. So he's not too hard to find. They did raise the price on these, $55 instead of $50. That's not as bad as Dirtbag and Ground Chuck, who were $64. However, since I bought Ground Chuck and Dirtbag at the same time as Wing Nut and Screw Loose, I talked to the cashier and they downed the price of Dirtbag and Ground Chuck for me, making them $55 to match Wing Nut and Screw Loose. So that's a little tip for anyone who hasn't bought these yet, who is wanting to talk to the cashiers. The cashiers are your friends. They will usually cut you some slack and give you them all for the same price. So the first accessory is interesting. It's a wanted sign for Smash, which is a new wanted sign. And we have these other stickers. Here's the W for Wing Nut, which the original action figure of him had a W on his chest. So I think they included this. So if you wanted to, you can put it on his chest. But in the cartoon, he didn't have the W on his chest. So that's completely optional. And I'm not sure what this thing is. I'm really, really not sure. Let me know in the comment section if you know what this third yellow sticker is. Next thing we got is comic books, little paper comic books they came with. So here is Bugman, which is cool because that, of course, is Michelangelo's favorite comic book, which, of course, turned out to be true. And it got the villain right there on front. And then on the back is an ad for Willy Wombat's Pizza Pan Theater, which is, you know, it's like their version of Chuck E. Cheese, where someone was using the robots to rob banks and stuff. So, yeah, that was 30 years before Five Nights at Freddy's. And then also we got this one, Creepy Eddie, who is the Ninja Turtle version of Freddy Krueger. And then we have the Big Bug-Eyed Alien Invaders. That's the actual comic, which is kind of perfect because that's what this whole episode was about. What's his name? Zach, the fifth turtle? What's his name, Zach? Anyway, yeah, he is always looking at the comic books of Alien Invaders, and everywhere he looks, he thinks he's seeing aliens. Then he gets sent to military school, where it turned out Screwloose and Wingnut are running a fake military school disguised as these soldiers, and they're really brainwashing the kids for their own army. And so Zach has to get in contact with the Turtles to get help to defeat Wingnut and Screwloose. And then, of course, there's also a comic of Captain Cow, another fictional comic character from the Ninja Turtles cartoon. And on the back of these, it's all like just blank comic panels. So those are some interesting accessories. Wingnut has some alternate hands. He has these big open claw hands, which are really cool. And he has the closed hands for holding accessories. So that is really something that is necessary. Also, Wingnut comes with this, the Disintegrator Bazooka. This is like the only weapon we see in that episode. He picks it up and he's like, I sure do love this Disintegrator Bazooka. And he just blasts the wall for no reason and destroys it. And he's like, you idiot, why are you always messing with that thing? So that is really cool that they got it. And it looks perfect. It looks just like it did in that episode of the show. So that's great. One thing to note, that Screwloose and Wingnut were only in one episode. So that's all they had to draw from, is that one episode. It's too bad they didn't just come with Zach. You know, Screwloose is kind of small, Zach is kind of small. I think it totally would have been worth it if they just stuck Zach in the pack also, had all three of them together. But oh well. Alright, the last item is a stand for flying. This appears to be the same one that the Ultimate Baxter Stockman Turtles in Time figure came with. So these things are really nice. It comes with this nice claw grip. And since Wingnut and Screwloose are both flying at characters, it is really nice that we have this now to be able to put them in the air. So let's go ahead. We'll put Screwloose there. And he can fly! Ha ha! So very cool. Friends, thank you for watching this unboxing review of Wingnut and Screwloose. Let me know in the comments section if you like these characters, if you're picking them up, if you've already got them in your collection or whatnot. What's your favorite version of Wingnut also? Because he, of course, was a hero in the Archie Comics. I think it was actually the Archie Comics version of him that was in Tournament Fighters. So I wouldn't be surprised if they made a figure of that version of Wingnut, since they're going to be making Tournament Fighters figures now. And then also, in the Nickelodeon cartoon, the CG one, Kirby Bat, April's dad Kirby, got mutated into a bat, and Michelangelo called him Wingnut as a nod to this character. But then I think they mostly just called him Kirby or Kirby Bat, and then it turned out Wingnut was a comic book character. Wingnut and Screwloose were like Batman and Robin, and they came to life in one episode. So that is also a weird interpretation of the characters. This is the only interpretation where they are bad guys, though. So that is very, very interesting. And yeah, I am just so happy to have this cool new Screwloose figure, for sure. All right. So, what figures do you want to see in tomorrow's video? Let us know in the comments section. Have a fantastic day, and happy TMN Turkey Week. Toast.